G'day, I'm Matt Cornell from Cornell Engineers. Today we're talking about Besser blocks and some of the questions that we get. So question number one is, do concrete masonry Besser block walls need to be reinforced? Yes, when we use them in residential construction, then yes, we do reinforce them. We need them to be strong enough to take loads from the wind and to carry the weight of roofs and to be strong enough so that if something or someone runs into them, that they don't crack excessively. We reinforce them with steel reinforcing bars which run vertically and horizontally, and we fill those cores that have got the steel reinforcement inside them with concrete. In this way, the Besser block becomes kind of like a formwork system to hold the strong cores of concrete. We do use the strength of the Besser block, but the steel reinforcement and the concrete inside the cores a very important part of holding the Besser block walls together. Now, the spacing and the location of those bars varies depending on whether it's a retaining wall or the wall of a dwelling, of a house. So for retaining walls, typically we're going to reinforce the walls at around 400 millimeter centers in both ways, that's vertically and horizontally. In a house, those loads are wind loads or people loads. Typically we have vertical bars at nice even centers at around 1 to 1.4 meter centers. And then we have strong pots along the top, which we call a bond beam, and we run reinforcement in those. And we have reinforcement above and below windows, all those places where walls will want to crack. Question number two, what are the standard sizes of a Besser block? In residential construction, we generally use 200 series blocks, which is the 190 thick wall. It's got a nice big pot in the middle, plenty of room. Because core fill is placed into the hollow cores from the top of the wall, it gives you a nice big hole to pour the core fill down to make sure that that concrete finds its way all the way down to the bottom of that vertical column of core. So 200 series is our preferred thickness of concrete masonry Besser block wall in residential construction and in retaining walls for the same reason. The other sizes are 150 series, which are 140 millimeters wide, a lot narrower and not nearly as much core room for the reinforcement and for the concrete to go down the middle. And then there's 100 series. They've got hardly any core if they have a hole at all. So they are essentially bricks rather than blocks. Now, don't forget, there are also 300 series blocks. All these series are really the thickness of the wall when it's built. Not so much the height, not so much the length of the blocks. There are variations and there are weird and different shapes of Besser blocks that you can buy off the shelf. And that allows you to build engaged piers and retaining walls better and maybe even swimming pools where the inside of the blocks need to be a little bit more hollow, a little bit more space and a little bit less Besser block. So those different shapes, they're all there for special purposes. 300 series blocks we do use in retaining walls. We use them down the bottom of a retaining wall where the forces are very large, and we need that extra thickness to get plenty of strength to make the retaining walls nice and strong. So that's our questions about Besser blocks answered. Let me know if you have any more questions and we'll see if we can help. I'm Matt Cornell from Cornell Engineers.